this is the 5 and 15 workout. We're gonna do 5 exercises, 3 rounds. We're gonna try to get it done in 15 minutes. It's always our goal. I've got no weights today unless you want to do weights. I'm gonna show you a couple of options. I am not doing weights for these exercises, but you can choose to do weights or not. The goal in all of this is to do as many as you can, as quickly as you can, going from exercise to exercise. Now, if you can do more than me, do more than me. If you can't do as many as me, don't worry about it. You're gonna put 100% of your energy in doing as many as you can until we switch to the next exercise. We'll do 3 rounds, and between each round, we're gonna take 1 drink of water, and then we're gonna go right back into it, which is why this is so effective, so quick. So the first one, I have an elevated surface. Now, in the gym, I would use a Bosu ball when I would do this, but I don't have a Bosu ball handy, and I know a lot of you don't. So I've taken 2 yoga blocks, and I put them together, and on top of it, I put this pretty sturdy blanket. So when I jump side to side, basically, I'm taking 1 foot, and I'm gonna switch opposite hand touches, switch opposite hand touches. So we're gonna do 20 of those. So just an elevated surface. If you have a, if you don't have an elevated surface, don't worry about it. You might even use a blanket, but I don't want you to trip. So if you don't have an elevated surface, same exact exercise, you just jump, going from thing, and again, jump up high enough to where you feel like you're kind of jumping up on an elevated surface. So you don't have this, no big deal. I'm gonna put this to the side for a moment, show you the other exercises. Exercise 2 is 1 leg squat. So you have a couple of options. This is one where you could use some weights if you want at your heart. You're gonna bend 1 knee. I'm gonna bring it all the way down to the shin, and I'm gonna try to come all the way back and press up. Now you wanna make it a little bit harder, you take your hands behind your head. This is called prisoner 1 leg squats. So, bringing it down, and then pressing up, trying to keep the leg up with you, that would be 1. So we're gonna do 20 of those, 10 on each side. All right, from there we're gonna do a lunge. The lunge is gonna be a wide lunge. So I'm gonna come into the lunge, we're gonna step forward. This arm steps out, and I'm gonna lift and extend that arm up. I'm gonna keep that arm out, press back, find my push-up, step, lift. So I'm lifting the opposite leg. I have to support here. If you're not able to get all the way forward, that's okay, come here. You can even use a block if you need to come up. Take the block, do your push-up, grab your block. I know sometimes it's not as quick, but you can find those nice options. So a block is handy. You can also use a block if you're not able to come down for that 1 leg squat. So some of my students will have a foot here. You can come all the way down, anything going on with the knees, try to lift the leg up. This is another option for your 1 leg squat. Okay, so the blocks can come in really handy. The next one we're gonna do is a bridge lift. Now I'm gonna rise up onto the toes. I want you to think about pressing into your hips. I'm going to stay up on 1 leg, the other leg straightens. I'm going to bring it down, lift up, squeeze the opposite glute. Keep your core really tight. We're going to stay up on those toes, and we're going to do 10 on each side. Then we'll switch to the other side. So we're doing a lot of 1 leg things today. Hands planted down for your next one. This is going to be your downward dog, 1 leg double jump. So I want you to think about in your 1 leg, you're going to squeeze the other leg in, just like we did for our squat. Now I'm going to jump this leg forward. 1, 2, 1, 2. Jumping back. So I'm hugging the abdomen in. And I'm going to go as fast as I can. Now on your abdomen, really strenuous, a lot of upper body work. If you're not able to jump that far, don't worry about it. Jump where you can, even if it's only an inch. You're changing it in, and squeeze your opposite leg into your core, and that's your exercises today. So if you have any trouble with those, feel free to message me after class. I always tape these so you can keep working on anything that you struggle with and have trouble with. All right, so we're gonna find those elevated jumps. I'm gonna place this right in the middle, and we're gonna go in 1, 2, 3. Let's start. So remember, oops, opposite hand, try to reach across and really jump up. And getting height. And we'll get 20 of these. And that's 20, basically, sets. So you're halfway. And really extend out. And try to get your hand all the way down. Come on, 5 more. 4. And 3. 2. Keep going. Last ones. Nice. Take this, put this to the side. Find your other side. So right leg is going to lift first. Maybe hands come behind. 1, 2, 3. Lower. Lift up. So we have 10 to each side. Push back into your heel as you lift up. So you're trying to lift as straight as you can up. Finding 5 more. And 4. Oh, 3. Try to get the foot not to help you. Last one. Oh, right foot down, left leg lifts. 1, 2, 3. Lower, lift. Push into your heel. Try to lift straight up. Keep breathing. 5 more. And 4. 3. Oh, 2 more. Come on. Last one. Oh, nice. All right. So lunges. I'm going to come down. Lunge plank. 1, 2, 3. Right foot, left foot out. Reach the left arm. Keep it out. Push up. Step. Lift. Now you need to drop the knees down for your push-up. Drop the knees or find a baby push-up. Four more. Three. Two more. Other side, so left, right hand steps out, reach that right arm up, big push up, reach, step out. You're almost halfway on this side, and I know some of these go a little slower, so work on your form. When you know you can't speed through it, notice what you're working. Keep breathing. Come on. Last two. Last one. Good job. Bring it down to the bottom. Come onto your back. Both toes come down. Lift the hips up, find your bridge pose. Left leg lifts, 1, 2, 3. So it's lower, press. And really tighten the glute. Lifting up. Let the heel hover. 5 more. 4, keep the right knee pointed forward. And 2, last one. Bring that leg down, right leg comes up, and go. Lower, press. So really press up, tops of the toes, working the glute. Keep going. 5, 4,
your first set.
3, 2, 1. Nice. Drop it down. Find your downward facing dog. I'm going to bring that right foot to the mat. Left leg comes up. 1, 2, 3. So let's hop forward. 1, 2, and 2 back. Now when you hop forward, slight bend in your elbows. And hop as far forward as you can. And pull the left knee as tight as you can. So you're going to notice the abdomen is really engaged. 3 more, 2, last one, nice, left leg down, right leg in, 1, 2, 3, go, forward, back, so it's a push, back, as well as a hop, 2 forward, keep that right knee tucked in, 2 back, come on, 3 more, 2 more. 1 more. Come on. You've got it. Oh, nice. Take that leg down. Grab your water. Get your reward. You have a moment to rest. Catch your breath. So we've got a little setup on the other side. So we're going to grab onto that stable surface. Place it right in the middle. Left foot's going to start. 2, 3, go. Opposite hand, try to touch the palm and down. Keep going. And again, it's that big jump. So you're already a quarter of the way there. Lifting up. Come on. Halfway. This is 9, then 8, and 7, 6, lifting up, 5, big movement, 4, 3, 2, last one, good job. So place that to the side. If you need that block, you can use that block. I'm going to bring that right leg down first. Maybe hands behind the head. 1, 2, I'm sorry, left leg down first. 1, 2, 3, go. So left leg comes down. Try to push through the right heel. And notice as you lean forward. Try to push straight into it so you're coming straight up. And I know when you're just trying to come up, straight up is pretty challenging. And kill some time, pressing up, and notice as you're here, that leg gets more fatigued because your form gets a little better. 3 more, pressing in, and 2, oh, come on, 1 more, come all the way down, come all the way up. Nice, left foot stays down. Right leg lifts, 1, 2, 3, go. And that right leg is working too. Try to keep and maintain its position. Push into the left heel. Keep the elbows facing back. Chest is facing forward. Find your balance. It is a wobbly kind of an exercise. Anything we do on one leg, we're getting the stability muscles active. We got 4 more. And 3. Come on. And 2. Pressing up. Last one. Oh, nice job. All right, so we're going to start on that other side first. So left leg is going to face forward, right leg, hand is going to come out. 1, 2, 3. So left, right hand comes out, reach, step back, push up. That push-up might be up on the knees. Find your variation, how far you think you can come down. No, we have quite a few of these. Maybe easing up, rotating the torso, keeping the elbows nice and wide. We've got three more. Two. Last one. All right, other side. One, two, three. So right, left arm comes out, reach up. Keep that left arm out and find that right leg. Reaching forward, work your abdomen here. Reach. Lower. Come on, we're almost halfway. Press those elbows out, chest forward, maybe gazing forward. Three more. Two. Last one. Oh, I'm down, nice job. Toes come in, heels come towards the bottom, lift up. Find your bridge pose. This time, your right leg's gonna come up, left leg stabilizes. One, two, three, lower, press. Now try to keep the right thigh and the left thigh facing forward. Squeeze into the glutes. Five more, four, three, two, one, and bring that leg in, lift. One, two, three, go. So push higher than you are in just that bridge. Lift, squeeze the glute, keep the right big toe down. Four more, three, two, one, reach, nice, press it down, bottom down. Find those downward facing dogs. So this time that right leg is gonna come in, squeeze it in, hop with the left, bend the left knee. One, two, three. So it's hop, 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 back. And find this movement. Try to bring it in, and every time you bring it in, squeeze that right knee in. Bend your elbows, soften your shoulders, and even hop back as far as you can. Making the distance wider as you do this. Three more. Two more. Come on, last one. Whew. All right, other side, same thing. One, two, three, hop. Bring it as close towards the thumbs as you can. And bring it back as far as you can. I always forget about that. Bring it back. Squeeze your left knee in. Bend your elbows. Come on, four more. Three more. Two more. Big jumps. Last one. Oh, nice. Step that foot down. Lock the hands in. I mean, this is where I was in the flight of grandma. I'm going to pound the pose. All right, so grab on your drink. You have one more round of these. We're doing awesome. Totally getting through our goal. All right, so again, make sure those blocks are together. Place that forward. You don't have the blocks, it's okay. One, two, three. So it's step, switch, opposite hand. So it takes my brain a minute to catch up with what my body is trying to do. And my brain and my body get on the same wavelength. As your breath is also trying to catch up with those two. So there's a lot of components going on that sometimes we think we're not strong, and that's not true. There's so much going on that's trying to strengthen. So we might be really strong cardiovascularly, but not in muscle or control. And we might be really strong in yogic control and not cardiovascularly. And then adding those two components in can be pretty challenging. You've got five more. Keep going. Three more. And two. And one. Oh, nice job. Take that over. And I want you to lift your right leg. We'll start on that left side. One, two, three, go. Try to press back into the heel. Press through the heel. Lift the body up as straight as you can. Let your breath catch up as your muscles work and fire. You're halfway. Squeeze your hip forward. Press into the glute. Try to lift your ears straight up as you're coming up. Three more. Two. And the last one. Nice job. Right foot comes down, left leg lifts. One, two, three. So these are really good ones to practice with. Try to keep the left leg up and not use the shin. So notice how much pressure you're putting on the shin as you lift up. Put that pressure in the heel, the glute, the quad. Keeping the core really tight in. Find a spot to focus on. Three more. I know these are really hard for me. And two. Come on. Last one. Nice job. All right. Don't have those anymore for a while. Take your hands down. Step out. Right leg is going to come first. One, two, three. Step. Reach up. Keep the arm out and push up. Chest is through the wrist. So try to kind of reach your chest through your wrist. See if you can keep your gaze forward as you do that. Come on, you have five more. Step back. And as you step back and step forward, see if you can do it without making a lot of noise with the foot. Come on. Two more. Last one. Reach. Nice. And I'm going to reach that left leg forward, right hand out, twist. Find your balance. Shoulders are reaching towards the fingers. Maybe the gaze is forward. Maybe the gaze follows the hand. So, little adjustments as you do this. Now see if you can pick up that foot a little more. So you're making a little less noise as you come forward and back. So as you perfect one thing, work towards the other. We need two more. Then we're done with this exercise. Come on, last one. Nice job. Bring your feet forward. Heels are pretty close in as I do this. Come on to your back. Rise up. Knees are forward, not out. Left leg comes up. One, two, three. So lower, lift. Power through your right glute. Right knee is facing forward, pushing your right big toe, pressing up. Come on, five more. Four. Three, squeeze. Two. One. Left foot down, stay up. One, two, three. Release. Press up. Left big toe presses in. Knees forward. Squeeze your glute on your way up. one, right leg comes up, bend your knee. One, two, three. So jump and back. Come on. Lift our knees out. This is three. Four. Five. Halfway. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Right leg down. Lift. One, two, three. Bend. Jump. Come on. One. Two. Three. Four. Hug the knee in. Five. Six. Come on, you're almost done. Seven. Eight. Nine. Come on. Ten. Woo. Good job. You did it. That was really hard. I know it was challenging, but you got through it. So I'm going to see you at the end of the week. Try to get these done with me 3 times a week. Post your results. Notice, tell me, are you feeling stronger? Are you feeling more confident? Is your agility getting better? Are these getting any easier? I know they're not for me, but if they're not getting easier for you, then you might be challenging yourself to do more and more. So start to notice where you're making these amazing changes in your body. My schedule is going to change a little bit, so please look at my schedule. I'm going to post that to my site, Shannon Sims, S-I-M-S. Be sure to find me, and you can comment if you're not a friend, but you're watching these via live. Just make a comment in the live section, and I will request you as a friend. So we can stay connected, keep doing these together. If you're watching these on my YouTube, comment, like, subscribe. It really helps. I'll keep bringing these, and we will get stronger and stronger together. Thank you so, so much, and have an awesome day.